With the geometry nodes, we will create a backdrop object that is always available in the asset browser. In our asset, we can adjust the width, height, length, depth, rounding, and resolution. We will also have the ability to show or hide a cube reference object. I'm using Blender 4.02's geometry nodes for this. There are 15 categories and 237 individual nodes within the geometry nodes. For our practical example, we will use 9 different nodes. Under the operations subcategory in geometry, we'll use the transform geometry and join geometry node to manipulate and combine shapes. Similarly, in the curve section, also under operations, the curve to mesh and fillet curve nodes will be key for converting curves into meshes and for creating smooth, rounded edges. In the point category, we use the points node to create individual points. These points are then linked together using the points to curves node to form a continuous curve. To manipulate the mesh geometry, we use the extrude mesh node in the operations category, which allows us to add depth and detail to our meshes. Finally, in the utilities section, specifically within the vector subsection, we'll employ the combine XYZ and the switch node, which are essential for managing vector operations and implementing conditional logic in our designs. I start the project by displaying the window for geometry nodes at the bottom. The cube is either activated in the outliner or we click it in the viewport. Then, in the geometry nodes window, we press New, step 1. Create the spline for the backdrop object. I press Shift plus A and go to Point, select the Points node and drag it onto the line. In the viewport, we now see the point at position 0 for X, Y, and Z. I select this point, press Shift plus D to duplicate it once below and once above. With Shift plus A, I go to Geometry and select the Join Geometry node, connecting all three points to it. It's important to follow the order from top to bottom. Move the bottom point by 1 on the X axis. Move the top point by 1 on the Z axis. Shift plus A, go to points and select the points to curves node. Shift plus A, go to curves, then operations, and then fillet curve, and set this to poly to add additional subdivisions. Step 2. Create the backdrop model. Shift plus A, select curve, then operations, followed by curve to mesh node. Next, we aim to extrude it. Press Shift plus A, go to mesh, choose operations, and select the extrude mesh node. Then set this node to edges because we want to extrude the created edge of our current mesh. We need to determine the extrusion direction along the Y axis, achieved using the offset value. Recognizing this as a vector with X, Y, and Z components, we must split it. Shift plus A, navigate to Utilities, pick Vector, then combine XYZ node. Here, all three axes are visible. Connect this node to offset and set X and Z to 0. Connect this node to offset and extrude the Y axis, for example, to 1. It would be better if our backdrop object is created from the center, extending outwards in both directions. Finally, we aim to mirror the entire geometry to the opposite side. To do this, press Shift plus A, navigate to Geometry under Operations, and create a Transform Geometry node. Drag our creation into this node and set the scale Y value to -1. Thus, we have mirrored the model to the opposite side. Duplicate the join node using Shift plus D, then connect the outputs from this node and the extrude mesh node. This process mirrors one half of our creation to the other side and joins them together. Step 3. Control the backdrop. First, we need to manage the backdrop's height and length. This can be done by adjusting the position of the points node, focusing on the Z and X values. To control these, we'll use the combine XYZ node again and split the vector once more. We duplicate the combine XYZ node twice with Shift plus D. Then I transfer the values from the points nodes and connect the nodes together. Drag the Z value from the upper node to group input to see its value in the modifier. Let's give the parameters clear names. Access the Group tab. If the Group tab is not visible, toggle it by pressing the N key. On the left side, you'll see inputs and outputs are on the right. To rename the Z parameter to height, double-click on it or press F2. Apply the same renaming process for the ground length. Drag the X value to a new slot in Group input and label it as length. For roundness, connect the radius value from the fillet curve to group input and rename it, perhaps to roundness. For mesh resolution, link the count parameter and rename it to subdivision. Now we want to control width and depth from outside. To manage the width, connect the offset scale value from the Extrude Mesh node to Group Input and rename this parameter to Width. Adjusting depth requires shifting the two points on the X axis. Duplicate combine XYZ with Shift plus D and attach it here. Set Z to 0 and link this to the second point. The X value from the upper points node is connected to a new group input entry, and also the X value from the second points node. We'll name this parameter Depth. We have now created a parametric backdrop object. Under the geometry node's modifier, we can conveniently adjust the height, length, width, depth, roundness, and subdivision. I want to enhance our backdrop object with a feature that allows the addition of a standard cube, which can be easily toggled on and off using a checkbox, just for reference. Shift plus A, select Mesh, then Primitive, and finally Cube. To display this cube alongside our backdrop object, drag the mesh socket into the Join Geometry node. Remember, the default cube in Blender measures 2 by 2 meters. Our goal is to position it accurately on the ground. This calls for a Transform Geometry node. Press Shift plus A and search for Transform. Link this with the cube and input a value of 1 under translate Z. This placement situates the cube precisely at the center of the coordinate system. Now adjust the properties of our backdrop object. Set the height to approximately 6, set the length to about 4, set the width to roughly 5, and the depth to around minus 5. For roundness, I'll take 2. To make it smoother, I'll use about 15 for the subdivision. Next, I want to include an option to toggle the cube's visibility directly in the parameters. Add a switch node from Utilities and connect it immediately after the Transform node. Ensure the cube is visible when the checkbox is marked True. And when this checkbox is turned on, the cube should be visible, so I'll take this connection and set it to True. Incorporate the checkbox parameter into the Group Input node. Rename this new parameter to Cube Visibility. And that's it, we're done. We'll now save our backdrop as an asset to ensure it's always accessible in Blender. First, rename the cube to Backdrop. Right-click on it and choose Mark as Asset. Next, split the node view and switch to the Asset Browser view. At the top, switch to Current File. Click the plus symbol to create a new catalog and label it as Backdrop. Select Unassigned, then drag the backdrop object into the backdrop folder. To make this asset readily available, save the scene in a folder where Blender is set to look for asset scenes upon opening. Navigate to Edit and then proceed to Preferences, followed by a selection of file paths. In this section, establish your own library by specifying the path to the folder where we saved the scene. Remember to save these settings. Click Save Preferences before closing the window. If Auto Save Preferences is enabled, this step will be automatic. I believe such information might be more tedious for you. After these settings are saved, close Blender. Upon reopening Blender, start by removing all existing objects. Access the Asset Browser, locate our newly created folder, and drag the file directly into the viewport. Reset all values to 0. You're now ready to set any desired perspective, then add or import your model of choice, easily adjusting the backdrop object to suit your needs. If you like the video and want to see more, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Have a great day!